From days of long ago, from uncharted regions of the universe, comes a legend.
Hi YouTube, it's Animated Plastic coming at you with another video review. This time it's the Toys R Us exclusive G.I. Joe Kreo build set, Cobra Armored Assault. Now this is the sixth of the seven sets I will be reviewing, and this is the sixth smallest or second largest of the build sets. It is the second largest of the five, what I call major build sets, not to discount the Ninja Temple Battle or the Checkpoint Alpha, but I'm basically talking about the ones that come with vehicles and pretty much a more complicated build than those were. So, not to say that they aren't a good set. And what I'll do here is actually take the time to link those reviews here right now, since I do have them all reviewed, and like I said in other ones, I will be linking all of them together, so that way when I'm done with a tactical battle platform or battle platform attack, whatever they want to call it, you will be able to jump around and watch them at your leisure as well. So hopefully you enjoyed that little stop motion animation at the beginning. And for you mobile users, sorry, right now at this point YouTube doesn't have the technology to display the links that I put on the video on your phone. So I have, for your convenience, I put them in the link below, so you can see all the other ones that I've already reviewed. So, and when the battle platform is done too as well, so if you're seeing this before or after, it will all be linked in there as well. So, alright, thanks for checking out my channel, and let's go ahead and take a look at the box and see what this set is all about. Now, I did get a chance to check out the G.I. Joe Retaliation in IMAX 3D, and I have to say that was a pretty nice movie. I did think it was a nicer movie than the first one. Totally different cast, so it's a totally different, like, I guess, feeling of the movie, but overall, I thought it was better. But I'm not going to talk about it too much, but I did, not too many spoilers here, guys. I'm guessing that if you've found my channel that you're probably a G.I. Joe fan and you've already seen the movie. None of the vehicles that we see in here are in the movie, so kind of a disappointment. And even the Hiss tank that was actually in the movie was nothing like the one we got, so hopefully, you probably already know that. So, anyways, let's go ahead and take a better look at the box. You got the typical G.I. Joe Kreo banner at the top with Storm Shadow and Snake Eyes, who was pretty much highlighted in the movie. You got Flint on his ATV, and then you got the armored assault vehicle. Basically, that vehicle I know was basically not a repaint, but like a recoloring brick of of the battleship set. So, not a bad use of it. I think it's actually kind of a cool vehicle. And when I open it up, we'll see how cool it really is. It does work with other brands like Lego and, I guess, Mega Block. It does come with three exclusive Kreons: Flint, Cobra Officer, and the Heavy Cobra Trooper. And it also says, do not be fooled by this cool picture. Basically, it's in a fantasy situation, and these vehicles really can't shoot. But I do know that the bazooka he has is a friction missile, and I think that these are ones where you push on the back that launch too. So they do launch, it just doesn't do what it shows in the package. It does have the piece count. It does have the exclusive Toys R Us sticker, which people have come to kind of hate in a sense. It shows Flint in this interesting position. I can't really tell what's going on the box, in the fact that they're right in front of him. He's popping his head out and shooting. And I guess they're hitting the vehicle, and he must be really talented because he can balance that and launch his missiles. But I guess, you know, he's G.I. Joe, so he can do pretty much anything. I just thought it was kind of an interesting picture on the front. On the top, it does show Flint and the two Cobra officers, or two Cobra troopers you get with the box. On the side, it does highlight Flint's pose from the Kreon, which I say is pretty cool. And then on this side, it does have the another G.I. Joe Kreo banner, and it's got the actual size of the Kreon Flint, I guess you get in it. And then on the back here, we have what comes in the set. It looks like it comes with an opening hatch here. I guess you can put the Cobra Officer in the driver's seat. It's got Flint here with his bazooka with the friction missile, which is pretty cool. Let's take a better look here. I got Flint in the bottom here, looking all cool. Like, dude, what's up, man? You got his ATV, and then it shows the three Kreons and with the weapons that come with them. And then it's got the missile launcher that you push in the back. It's not spring-loaded, but I have to say that I think the some of the other some of the other builds had these weapons, and they're actually pretty good. So, I mean, for having no springs in them, they launch pretty well. It looks like it has a little panel in the back, too, that you can store all the weapons that come with it as well. So, I'll just take a little better look. There's the Cobra Officer, and then there's a Cobra Heavy Trooper. Looks like he comes with quite a bit of gear. And the ATV, and there on the bottom it has the disclaimer that says, you know, requires hand support to, you know, play with the poses shown. And then on the bottom it highlights the major build sets that are out right now: the Thunderwave Jet Boat, which I reviewed, Serpent Armor Strike, and then the Tactical Battle Platform, or that they call the Battle Platform Attack. So that one is coming up next. And let's do this. Let's go ahead and take this guy out of the package and see how cool it really is. All right, go ahead and open this thing up and see what we get inside. Looks like it comes with one bag of parts. Oh, and then there's the elusive red Kreo display block for the Kreon. And like I say in all my reviews, I really wish Hasbro would include more than one. One for each one of the Kreons you get in the set would be actually really nice. Since it is probably not that expensive to put in that sense, and it would be a nice way to display your fans. Another bag of small parts, so that's three. Bag of small parts, four. And a bag of really tiny parts, and that would be five. So it looks like there's five bags for the build sets. Then you get the Cobra Officer with his weapon, his helmet. Cobra Heavy Trooper. Doesn't look like he comes with everything. I think he comes with a vest, a bulletproof vest as well. So, looks like some of the parts are not in the bags with him. And you get Flint with his beret, his shotgun, and yeah, I think on the box I saw him have a, let's take a look at the display. It looks like he comes with a backpack there. So, I'm going to say, let's take a look here. Yeah, there's Flint's backpack, and I think that there is other parts for the, you know, there's another weapon. So, looks like they're not all in with the Kreons in the packs. Comes with a sticker sheet. Not too bad. It looks like there's some cool display stickers there for the vehicle. A lot of no-step. Some people have nightmares about no-step. And then it comes with a color instruction booklet. Full color, yeah. So, one thing I recommend with the build sets, at least this is what I do, is I actually, when I take them out, I break them out by color. Just makes it easier to build, since the instructions basically do call for the pieces by color as well. So I find it takes a little bit of time, but it makes the build so much more enjoyable and easy to put together. The only time sometimes I have a little bit of trouble with clear versus the gray. Sometimes the colors in the instruction can be a little bit off, but for the most part, I have not had a problem with any of the build sets, with the G.I. Joe Kreo build sets. So so go ahead and sit back, relax. I'm going to go ahead and do a stop motion build of this nice set, and then I will go into a little more in-depth review of each one of the figures as well as the vehicles in the Cobra Armored Assault set. So sit back, relax, and stay tuned. okay, here it is all assembled. Hopefully you enjoyed that little stop motion build. It was pretty fun to make. This is a pretty neat little set. Enjoyed it. There wasn't a whole lot of stickers on this one. Wasn't too bad. And it was pretty, I think it was pretty straightforward as far as putting it together, as far as challenging. I don't know. I mean, I think that the Cobra Assaulter vehicle was probably the most challenging part of it all. And a majority of the bricks are used in this actual vehicle itself. So I'm going to go over the Kreons first. So let's go ahead and take them out of the vehicle. And oops, took the chair with him. So I will start with Flint. Flint comes with this nice little missile launcher. It actually is a friction missile, so hang on. So I mean, it does a pretty good job launching. Let me see. So I mean, it's pretty cool, and it's I think unique. I haven't seen a bazooka in one of the Kreon sets that I've actually bought yet, or I actually put together. So it's pretty neat. It is friction based, so you just basically push down on that, and it will launch. So that is pretty neat. He does come with his backpack. It is pretty nice. It's got some detailing on it, a couple straps. He does come with his beret with a little red symbol on the front. I think that's a different symbol than Sergeant Stalker had in his set. And I'm going to go ahead and take his hat off. You can see he has a hairline. And he's actually got a line where I guess the beret comes down. I don't know if that's was on there before or after I put the hat on. So let's go ahead and take his backpack off so you can take a look at him full without the so he's got some really nice paint apps on him. He's got the brown hands, the shoulders with a full sleeve. I mean, the paint on the arms match the body as well as the head. There is nothing on the back. He does have some pretty nice paint apps, a little camo going on his thighs with some pouches. He's got, I guess, cargo pants on. And then he's got some silver for his bootstraps. The front of his feet are painted black to give him the simulation of boots. And he has, these are ammo belts that are on his chest as well. So very real American hero homage to Flint. It is nice that he got his backpack. Oh, and he did get a shotgun. I don't know why they chose green for it, but it is a nice shotgun. Maybe that's like the original one as well. I don't remember Flint, because I didn't have him when I was a kid. I don't know if he did actually come with a shotgun. And I'm going to put Flint on the only Kreo block that you get to display. Unfortunately, Hasbro only gives you one. I wish they would give you three, one for each Kreon. That is something I say in every review. Sorry. The next one is the Cobra Heavy Trooper. In the instructions, it shows to put this one on there. I think you can clip it on here as well if you wanted to. You don't have to put it there. You can put it in the front there as well. I don't know. I don't know how that makes it a Heavy Trooper. But it is the standard machine gun. He does come with a helmet. And then he has the a different face mask. He's actually got the red goggles and a face mask. So it is nice. He's got these nice gray shoulders. Has a nice Cobra symbol on it as well. Has his black gloves. And then I'm going to take the bulletproof vest off that he comes with, which has some nice detailing on it as well. And it has the thing in the back that allows you to connect stuff to it. Underneath, he has a very simple shirt design. It's like a polo shirt. And he's got a nice Cobra symbol on it as well. It's got some lines for wrinkled parts of the shirt. It's got a collar and a few buttons. Nothing on the back. On the legs, you have some, I guess those are knee guards. And he's got boots painted on. And he's got a couple straps there on the thigh as well. Not really sure what that's for. So overall, nice, another nice Cobra
troop builder. I think he's only available in the assaulter vehicle. Next one is the Cobra Officer, who comes with the standard, looks like AK-47 machine gun. He has a nice black symbol on his helmet, which I guess signifies he's an officer, which does come off. He has the disgruntled look on his face with the mask. He does have a different paint scheme on the front, I guess, for being an officer. He has a couple of, he has a bunch of pouches on the front. He's got a red one. He's got a couple of pouches on the front. He's got a belt buckle. A couple of straps painted on his thigh, and the front is black. He does have the black gloves, and that's it. There's no other paint apps on him. He does have the nice silver Cobra symbol in the middle as well. So, overall, nice, another nice Cobra Troop figure. I don't know about Army Builder, but he is nice in the as far as the set. Now I'm going to move on to the little AT vehicle we get with Flint. It is pretty nice. It's actually got the handlebars on this little swivel, so you can move them back and forth. There are some clips, so I am assuming you can maybe clip the grenade launcher, missile launcher on like that if you want. It is clippable on the front as well. You can probably clip his shotgun on there. And as you saw in the little stop motion, as well as from when I pulled him off, I did put his shotgun in one of these little holes as well. So this peg does fit. Oh, maybe this one doesn't fit in there. It doesn't seem to fit very well. It did go in, but I don't think it fits very well in there. The shotgun does fit in that little thing as well. So it does have a grill here, and these headlights are on little swivels. So not much more to it. It does have a little thing in the back that allows you to hook it up to something. I'm not really sure what. I'm going to go ahead and put the missile launcher on the back, which is actually pretty nice for storage. So overall, nice little vehicle. It does have real rubber tires. It does roll okay. It does seem to have a little bit, I don't know if it's because of the way the wheels are ridged. A little more trouble rolling, I think, than the other ones. So, next is this Cobra Assaulter vehicle. It does have this swivel here at the top, and as you can see, there's a little a targeting system up there as well. And then it does have these missiles. They're not friction-based, but they are ones you can you push on the back, and it does pop them out. So they are pretty good. These are pretty solid as far as missiles. These are on swivels, hinges, so they do go up and down. On the side here, it does have these as well that go up and down. And there are things you could probably attach to the side as well. This is hinged, so it does come up. It allows you access to the back of the vehicle. And this does come down in a hinge. And this is really what I thought was kind of nice, is there's like a little weapons armory that you can slide out of the back of the vehicle. It is pretty nice. It slides in. It fits pretty well. And it's clear, so it doesn't hit the top of this. So it's pretty nice. It comes with a, looks like a sniper rifle. It does come with a 9mm hand pistol. And then what I think is a pretty cool weapon is this little grenade launcher chambered weapon, which is pretty neat. And then it does come with a couple of grenades as well. So overall, I think it's pretty neat that you get a little armory that you can attach other weapons to, and it does come out. I guess when you're in a fight, you can set this up over on the side and have it out on the battlefield whenever you're doing it. Inside, you'll see that there is a couple of stickers that you see. Let's see here. Get a better look. And then there is a little computer in the back. I don't know if you can get a good look at that. The sticker is pretty cool. It's got a little radar symbol on it. On the top, it's got these two as well. They say stay clear. It doesn't say no steps, so you can't have nightmares about that. But this is pretty neat. It does come down, and it does it closes pretty well. This is on a swivel, so it goes 360 degrees, which is actually pretty nice. I think this is a pretty neat little vehicle. It does come with six wheels, which it does roll pretty well. In the front, it has these little headlights, which do swivel. And then it has a couple different swivels. It's got the whole top that comes out. And as you can see, it's got a cockpit. It's got a little steering wheel. Let's see if we can better look at it inside. And it's got these two stickers here. It's like a temperature gauge, and this is like, I don't know, like an authorization panel. It's kind of weird. I'm not sure what this one really is. It has a steering wheel. It's kind of a faux seat there. And then also, too, when this is closed, it's got this little panel that opens up in the front, too, as well. So you have kind of a dual action going on here where you can open up both like that. So it's kind of neat. Overall, it's a pretty nice little vehicle. It only holds two characters. I guess if you take out the back, you could put a Kreon in the back. I think they have to be sitting for it to work, because I don't think it'll allow them to stand in the back and go down fully, because their head will be in the way. Let's see here. Position the feet. Yeah, see, like it'll hit his head. So I think they have to be sitting. So you could probably fit sitting maybe like a couple of Kreons in the back. So it could be a nice little transport vehicle, and you could put this off to the side. Didn't have to use it as a thing in the back. But I actually think that's pretty cool, the fact that it is something that slides into the back. And it is storable in the back as well. So that is pretty cool. And the fact that you get a bunch of extra weapons along with the vehicle that you get. So overall, I would recommend it. This guy can actually hang out up here on the top. And I guess he can target stuff with the missiles. So this guy, when you put him in here, I found it's easiest to open the whole thing up, put him down. And then I take his weapon off. So, yeah, this is the first time that happened. But I guess if you put too much pressure on the this front part, it doesn't stay on very well if you push down too hard, because there's nothing holding this thing in. So overall, it's a nice little vehicle though. And I just take that off, and then I just set him in there. And then this closes down on it. So overall, it's a pretty nice vehicle. Pretty much my only gripe on it is the fact that you only get one Kreon display block. And this thing right here tends to come off a little bit as well. So you put any kind of pressure on this, it comes off pretty easily. So other than that, I would totally recommend getting this set, especially if you wanted a Cobra vehicle to move your troops and stuff with. I believe this one is about the same price as the Thunderwave Jet Boat. It could be a little bit more. I think actually it's about $5 more, just for, 30 more pieces. Plus, you get a couple of cool weapons. You get the missile launcher, and you get these cool missile launchers here at the top, and some extra weapons and an armory. So overall, I'd say it's worth what you pay for it. So that's it, guys. Thanks for checking out my channel. I am at 75 subscribers now, so thank you very much for all the support. I'm looking forward to the push to 100. When I get there, I will have all my reviews completed, and I will have my little homage that I wanted to do for hitting 50 subscribers, but looks like I'll be closer to 100 by the time I get done reviewing all the pieces that I have in these, as far as the G.I. Joe sets. So subscribe, you'll be notified when I upload new videos. The last set will be on the way here. It will be the Tactical Battle Platform, which is the largest of the sets. It comes with a lot of cool little little vehicles, as well as a bunch of Kreons you get with it as well. So, all right, guys, thanks again for your support. Stay tuned, and remember, knowing is half the battle. Yo, Joe.